Hello dear students, in last lecture we have discussed about the detailed structure and structural arrangement of different nitrogenous bases paired to sugar phosphoric acid inside the DNA strand and how double-stranded DNA helix can be formed with respect to parallel and anti-parallel arrangement of nitrogenous bases. We have also discussed different forms of DNA with respect to A form, B form, Z form, C form, D form. So they are nothing but a rotational changes can be appear in the form DNA strand. That's why this different form can be appear. In this lecture, we will discuss about the another nucleic acid, that is RNA. Basically, in first lecture we have discussed about the environment. There are two different types of nucleic acid can be present. That it is DNA deoxyribose nucleic acid or RNA ribose nucleic acid. So basic structural difference between DNA and RNA is nothing but the presence of deoxyribose sugar and absence of, or the presence of ribose sugar in case of RNA and presence of deoxyribose sugar in case of DNA. So in this lecture we will discuss about the structure of RNA. It is nothing but in last lecture we have already discussed DNA molecule is nothing but a hereditary molecule. It carries the genetical information of that individual and that can be transferred from one generation to another generation. So in case of RNA, it is nothing but it is again another form of nucleic acid, and it located in both cytoplasm as well as in case of nucleus. Normally, while discussing about the DNA, DNA is normally present inside the nucleus or at the center of the cell, and all the cellular processes are in control of the DNA. While in case of RNA, it is present in both position, that is in case of cytoplasm it also found, and in case of nucleus it also present. So RNA is present in both cytoplasm and nucleus also. It also present in mitochondria and in chloroplast. Apart from cytoplasm and nucleus, RNA molecule can be present in mitochondria and in structure of chloroplast in case of plant cells. So irrespective of structure of DNA or RNA, DNA normally present in the nucleus, but in case of RNA it is present different location, that is either chloroplast, mitochondria, cytoplasm or nucleus. So these are the different position where RNA molecule can be formed. It contain ribose sugar and thymine is replaced by the uracil. In case of RNA structure, normally we can say it is nothing but a nucleic acid, and it is composed of a nitrogenous bases, ribose sugar and phosphoric acid molecule. But in the case of RNA, it contains ribose sugar, while in case of DNA, it contains deoxyribose sugar molecule. And another structural change in case of RNA, that is thymine molecule, is present in case of DNA, is replaced in case of RNA by means of uracil. So in the nucleotide sequence, we normally see if we have a single stranded RNA, single strand of nucleic acid, and it contains a uracil molecule. So uracil nitrogen base, so normally we can say it is nothing but a RNA strand. Thymine is replaced by means of uracil in case of RNA. It is a, and ribose molecule is present in case of RNA. It is single stranded, consisting of single polynucleotide chain. RNA molecule are single stranded, and it is again a polynucleotide chain. Continuous arrangement of nitrogenous bases are present by means of this ribose sugar and phosphoric acid molecule. All the structural arrangement are similar to that of the DNA molecule, but only change is that ribose sugar is present in the case of deoxyribose sugar, and thymine is replaced by the uracil. mRNA, rRNA and tRNA. mRNA, messenger RNA, ribosomal RNA and transfer RNA. These are the different types of RNA, and they play an important role in the protein synthesis. Normally, for each and every prokaryotic or eukaryotic organisms, major metabolic process which is carried out inside the cell, that is replication and protein synthesis. In both the cases, these ribosomes carried out a most important crucial role in this protein synthesis mechanism. Okay, so it is nothing but a basic structural information about the RNA. Now we discuss about the what type of functions that RNA molecule play inside the cell. So in this we have to discuss about the different functions of RNA. They play an important role during the process of protein synthesis. In last slide we have also discussed mRNA, tRNA, rRNA. These are the different forms of RNA, and each forms of DNA, so RNA has an important role in the case of protein synthesis. They carry the message by means of messenger RNA. In case of ribosome, they bind it to ribosome molecule. Transfer RNA, they carried out this different types of functions in the this process of protein synthesis. Apart from the protein synthesis, they play an important role in replication of DNA. In case of normally we can say each cell has the ability to replicate, and while replication or multiplication, cell is dividing by equal distribution of the all cellular components. So that process is carried out by means of replication, that is replication of genetic material. So in the case of replication, RNA play an important role. In case of RNA primer, we start the replication process or complementary strand formation in this case. So in case of protein synthesis is also important role. In case of RNA replication, it plays again another most crucial role in case of replication process. In some viruses, RNA functions as a genetic material. Apart from this important role in replication and protein synthesis, some viruses has a genetic material as a RNA. Okay, so apart from DNA, RNA is also nothing but a genetic material. In case of RNA, it is normally the structure of RNA which is form or present in the cell. So these are the most important function which carried out by the presence of RNA. In this slide we will discuss about the different basic differences between DNA and RNA. Normally you can say both are nucleic acids. Apart from that, they have a basic differences in that. In case of DNA, it is present in case inside the nucleus, as there is the major component of cell. All the genetic information is stored in the DNA, that's why they are present in the nucleus of the cell. In case of RNA, they are present in nucleus, cytoplasm or mitochondria or chloroplast. So RNA are present at nucleus and cytoplasm also. DNA are double stranded. When talking about the DNA, they are always double stranded DNA, while in case of RNA, they are single stranded RNA. RNA are single stranded. So in case of DNA, it contains deoxyribose sugar. Ribose sugar which is present in the DNA, it is deoxyribose. It loses its oxygen molecule from second position, and that is deoxyribose sugar. It is present in DNA molecule, where in case of iodine contains carbon ferrose ring, sugar ring, which is ribose sugar, it present in case of RNA. Nitrogenous bases are never exposed, as that DNA strand is double stranded and nitrogenous bases are arranged at the center of that strand and at the periphery sugar molecule and phosphoric acid molecule is present. That's why nitrogenous bases are protected inside the axis, or we can say that strand, while in case of RNA it is single stranded. That's why nitrogenous bases are exposed to the cytoplasm or other components. So in case of DNA they are protected, while in case of RNA they are exposed. Here purine and pyrimidine ratio is 1:1. It is the 4 carboxyl we have already discussed. Total number of two purine molecule is always equal to the total number of purine-pyrimidine bases, but as if in case of complementary base pair. But while in case of RNA, there is no double strand or it is always present in single strand form, so there is no complementary base pairing. That's why that law, that is purine to pyrimidine ratio, that is 1:1, it is not applicable here. It replicate to form daughter DNA molecule. DNA molecule, by the process of replication, it replicate to form a daughter DNA molecule which can be transferred to the newly synthesized cells, while in case of RNA it cannot replicate, but it play an important role in the process of replication. Hereditary material in all organisms except some viruses. DNA is a genetic material, or you can say hereditary material. It store all genetic information on DNA. Sometimes it present as a genetic material in case of viruses also. It is hereditary material in some viruses. It is nothing but a about RNA cells. So sometimes some viruses it has genetic material as a RNA. It is component of chromosome. DNA acts as a main component of the chromosome. It is component of ribosomes. Okay, so it is nothing but a basic differences between DNA and RNA. It control protein synthesis and it brings about protein synthesis. So basic structural changes as well as their functional differences we have discussed. It control all the already we have discussed. All the cellular mechanisms are in control of DNA, so it carried out the protein synthesis mechanism. While successfully completion of the protein synthesis mechanism, RNA play an important role. So these are the different differences between DNA and RNA. So basic structural structure molecular level of DNA and RNA we have discussed. Their differences we have also discussed. In next lecture we will discuss about the different experiment to prove DNA as a genetic material.